Hello dear watercolorists, and thank you so much for watching this video. Today we're gonna paint American flag since we're in the 3rd of July and we're getting ready for the Independence Day. I figured this would be a fun painting to do. So we're gonna use a watercolor paper, and for that I chose my new canson notebook and a round brush that's 8 or above and a silver black velvet sharp brush. I couldn't take one more step. I can't remember if I cried when I read about his widowed bride, but something touched me deep inside the day the music died. I chose to preserve the white using a masking fluid, which I recently purchased from Amazon, but this is pretty expensive, so if you don't have it, you can skip it and go around the white areas, or use a waxing crayon, which is very easy to find. Just make sure you get a white one in order to have your clean paper. If you smudge it off, it will leave a residue, a colorful residue. With the paper around the flag, I use this brush to spread the water around it, and then I apply the color. It's gonna be a wet on wet mostly, and I'm gonna fade everything away towards the end of the flag because I want to achieve this dissipating effect. For more texture, I'm gonna add salt and I'm gonna drop some drops of water. Because I forgot to record this side, I'm not gonna see how I put my stripes in the blue, but just go ahead and add your ultramarine blue for the stars. And for the stripes, any red is good. I use the cadmium red. I'm trying to get it to look more dynamic and also pick up the warmth of the sun, and you can always show that warmth through adding yellow, or in my case a yellow ochre, which is more toned down version. I'm trying to follow the patterns that I already sketched. And I'm using this stripper silver brush black velvet, which has the pointy. Since I got this brush, it's pretty much the one that I use on any painting, and sometimes it's the only brush that I'm using for the same painting, so it is very versatile. So I highly recommend you getting one. Stripper and round brushes are good as well, but sometimes you feel like you don't have accuracy, like you're painting with your tongue. You can go ahead and count your stars just to make sure you have 50. If you don't worry about it, because as long as your flag is flying in a wind and it's not straight, you can't tell very well, so don't worry about that. focus on achieving those dark areas. The shade needs to go to be consistent and to make sense with the curved lines in the jewelry traced. Okay, I'm sorry, just got a message. And I think we're done. Go ahead and take off the masking fluid. Take the salt grains off and get ready to frame it and take it to the party. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Please like and subscribe. And hit that bell button to get notifications for my next video so you won't miss one. Thank you so much. Happy painting and happy 4th of July. Bye bye.